everybody. Greg Wilkins, back here with you with another edition of the Daily Pause, a devotional of positivity and encouragement for Thursday, September 15, 2022. I pray that you not only have a very blessed day today, but that today's devotional will help encourage, inspire, and motivate you, as well as put a smile on your face. If you enjoy the Daily Pause devotional, make sure you hit that like button and be sure to follow and subscribe to the Daily Pause on my Facebook page, The Daily Pause, on my YouTube channel, Greg Wilkins, and you can also follow me on Twitter at GregWilkins78. And if you know someone else who might be blessed by today's devotional, feel free to share this episode with them and also encourage them to like, follow, and subscribe to the Daily Pause devotional. My goal and desire for each devotional is that everyone that you watch, it gives you the encouragement to continue to press on and strive to be the best that you can be on any given day. And remember, God loves you, God cares for you, and God will always, always be there for you. Well, let's get started with today's devotional entitled, Yeah, But The Return of the What Ifs. Ever since eighth grade, I have always wanted to be involved in science. My main goal and desire was to go to Clemson or Georgia Tech, hadn't decided which one at the time yet, and major in chemical engineering. That was my goal and desire ever since the eighth grade. And as I got to my sophomore year in high school, my English teacher, Mrs. Johnson, gave us all an assignment based on the reading assignments that we had over the summer. We had to pick a book and we had to do a special assignment on it. Now, I've been in the band since the seventh grade, and my family has been enthralled in music every which way you go. Every member of our family, one way, shape, or form, loved or involved themselves in music. And I was no different. And of course, I was in the band and I love the band. And so I decided, well, I play piano at my church. Let me get something together and create a song based off one of these books. I chose the book A Separate Piece by John Knowles, and I wrote a little synopsis of what I thought the book was like. It was about 7 minutes long, and I performed it in class. I borrowed my cousin Chris, I borrowed his keyboard, and I brought my keyboard and plugged it in and recorded half of it on one and played the other half while the other one was playing. And she told me years later that in all the years of doing that assignment for her class, I was the only person to get a perfect score on both the presentation and the direct tiedness. That's not a proper way to say it, but how it closely directly tied to the book I was doing the thing about. So it made me think, maybe I could do this music thing. So I scrapped the chemical engineering thing and started looking for colleges that had great music programs. And of course, I was already being influenced by my band directors, whether they knew it or not. They were both from Furman University. And every year we would go to region band at Furman. And so I was already familiar with the campus. I fell in love with the campus and I was familiar with everyone there and all how it went. But yet I applied to other places. I applied to Winthrop University in Rock Hill. Of course, I applied to the University of South Carolina in Columbia. I still applied to Clemson because maybe I thought I could do music on the side, like be in the orchestra or something, like still be in the band. But so I still didn't get rid of the chemical engineering idea. Then I found out there was a dual degree program with Clemson and Georgia Tech. So I really started looking at that more. But all the while, I still really was focusing on music. I applied to Seton Hall in South Orange, New Jersey. I applied to DePaul University in Chicago. I applied to Northwestern, although I didn't really go heavy on Northwestern, but I applied nonetheless. And I got responses from everywhere but Northwestern. And DePaul really, really pressed me. Seton Hall really, really pressed me. And you really wanted me to go there and major in music. And the further I got, I narrowed it down to music theory and composition. And Seton Hall's music theory program was great. South Carolina's music theory program was great. And Furman's music theory program was great. And so I eventually narrowed it down to Seton Hall, Winthrop, South Carolina, and Furman. And of course, had to take the SATs. That one time I took the SATs, one and only time, I got the flu. But I still took it, and I was greatly surprised to see that I scored a 1270. At that time, the SAT max score was 1600, not 2400 as it is now. So that was great. I was so excited. So I took all this information, and I went to my guidance counselor. And I told him about all the places I applied to. I told him about all the responses that I got. And I felt great about all the head work I was putting in, starting my sophomore, going into my junior year. And right at this point, towards the end of my junior year, going into my senior year. And he was like, well, this is all great, but your SAT score doesn't mean you're going to be accepted by any college. You still got to have great grades. And I reminded him, like, you do realize I'm in the top 10 in the class, right? Yeah, but I just want to make sure that you understand that you're not getting in over your head. I want you to go to somewhere that you know you can get into. So I left a little frustrated after that. Going into my senior year, I got the flu again. And I ended up in the hospital and I came back out and applied, did the region auditions, and I made the all-state cut. And it turned out I was the third best tuba player in the state, behind Demetrius, who was from T.L. Hanna, and Matt, who was from Bowling Springs. Now, they were also the top two in our region. So the three of us were the three best tuba players in the entire state of South Carolina at that time. And I took that information about, yeah, that doesn't mean anything. It just means that you're great. And it's great, no, great accomplishment. But you need to understand, you need to still focus on your grades. And you need to find some other things that you do in your community to help bolster your resume to get into the college you want to go to. Now, by that time, I had narrowed it down to South Carolina and Furman. Although I kept getting offers from Winthrop, I narrowed it down to South Carolina and Furman. And I got acceptance letter from USC first. And then they got an invitation to audition to their School of Music, which I did. And I got accepted in South Carolina. And my guidance counselor said, well, that's great, but that doesn't necessarily mean that you should go there. You should probably rethink and rehash where you're going. And so I applied to Furman, and I went to the Furman audition. And not too long after that, they gave me a $10,000 a year scholarship from the Department of Music. And I told him about that. And he went, yeah, but that doesn't mean you've been accepted yet. I hadn't gotten an acceptance letter from Furman yet. So don't put all your focus on that. Now, by that time, I had chosen Furman as my go-to, although South Carolina was a good backup. But all these yeah buts kept getting me frustrated, kept getting me aggravated. It made me start to wonder, am I cut out for college? Because my guidance counselor actually told me, maybe you should skip a year. Take a year off to think about it, then apply to another college later. He actually told me that. So I started thinking, am I good enough to go to college? I know my grades are good, but maybe I'm not good enough as a person to go to college. Maybe I'm not good enough to go to the college I want to. Maybe I'm actually not good enough to graduate. I actually thought that. I thought something was going to happen at the last second, and it's not going to make me qualified to graduate high school. And kept getting frustrated, kept getting aggravated. And one of my band directors, Jim Hembry, pulled me to the side and said, don't let anybody tell you how you should feel about where you want to go. It's your life. You got to make that choice for yourself, and you got to stick to it, and you got to press forward to it. You got to keep doing your best. You got to let all that negative stuff go. I don't care who it is. You got to let it go. And I remember that, and I kept remembering those yeah buts. I kept remembering those yeah buts, and it really, really hurt. It really, really hurt that somebody who was supposed to be the one helping you was one of the ones seemingly sabotaging everything you were doing. All the college applications, they tell people to jump on it. A lot of people got started late. I started early. I really made up my mind. I narrowed it down, took my time and really thought about it, did all the things right, but kept hearing, yeah, but, yeah, but, yeah, but, yeah, but, yeah, but. And it really, really started to frustrate me. The words that Mr. Henry told me really, really encouraged me to keep on going. But still, at the back of my head, those yeah, buts were lingering. And one day I walked into the band room, and Mr. Henry was on the phone. He's like, yeah, he's right here. He's right here. I'm like, oh no, what did I do? And he handed me the phone, and it was the director of admissions at Furman. He said, we just wanted to call you and let you know that you're accepted into Furman University. We're working on your financial package right now. And I handed the phone back to Mr. Henry, and he said, what they say is that you're accepted. I got accepted into Furman. And he's like, yeah. And he patted me on the back, and we were all excited. And he got back on the phone with the lady, and he asked her what she's doing. She's like, I'm sending all his financial package, getting there. He's like, wait, do you have a fax machine? Like, yes. All right, send it here. I'm gonna give you the number to my fax machine in my office. Send it here. And that's what she did. And when all that information came in, he said, you take this and you take this to your guidance counselor, and all I want you to say is, I got an acceptance letter from Furman University, and here's what they're paying for, and walk away. And that's exactly that. I knocked on his door and I said, well, hey, Greg, how you doing? How's the college search going? Oh, it's going great. And I set it on his desk. I said, I just got accepted into Furman University. This is what they're giving me. And I walked away. Now, I told you that story to emphasize the yeah buts that come into our lives. We do our best. We are great. We have every intention of having a great day. And we go over and we hop over hurdles and bust through obstacles and roadblocks and all kinds of things that are hindering us from our forward progress. And we do our best and we do our best and we do our best and we do our best. And yet there's always one person who always seems to come up with those two simple and most devastating words you could ever hear after you accomplish something. Yeah, but... And it just cancels everything you did. That yeah agrees with everything you did, but is about to cancel what they agreed with you with. So they come with, yeah, but it doesn't mean that you're the best. It just means that you accomplished this. Yeah, but like my guidance counselor told me, yeah, you got that scholarship, but it doesn't mean that you're accepted yet. Yeah, but you got that 1270, but it doesn't mean that you'll be going to college. It doesn't mean you're actually great for college. Maybe it's not for you. And all those things can hurt. Words can hurt and discourage, or words can build and encourage. We got to choose which ones we want to accept. Now, we can't control the words that come at us, but we can definitely control which words we remember. And the words we remember not only come through the yeah buts, but it takes us down that familiar avenue that leads us to the neighborhood of what we here at the Daily Pause call the what ifs. And then we start all those questions. Well, what if he's right? What if my grades aren't good enough? What if my SAT is not good enough? What if they look at me and they start to judge me for my skin color? What if my job doesn't think I'm good enough? What if they've been lying to me all this whole time, just helping me go along? They didn't want to tell me the truth that I'm not good enough. What if the people around me are laughing behind my back? What if, what if, what if? What if I go here, I miss an opportunity here? What if I don't go here and I miss an opportunity altogether? What if I do this? What if I don't do this? What if I did that? What if I didn't do that? And those start to come into our heads and it makes us start to doubt. And the doubt brings about the worry. And the worry brings about the fear. And the fear takes away our hope. And like I said on yesterday, when we don't have hope, we have no forward momentum. Hope is explicitly linked to our faith. And when we pray about things and we don't operate in action and in faith and in hope, nothing happens. That door, that key just stays in the door and the keychains are swinging in the ruin because we put no action in opening anymore because our hope is gone. Why should we hope for anything that we don't think is there anymore? And that's what the yeah buts that lead into the what ifs can do to us. But like I said just a few seconds ago, we've got to choose what we remember. And we got to remember that what God started in our lives, he's going to perform it until the very end. He said he would never leave us nor forsake us. His word will not return unto him void, but it will accomplish that which he pleases. And it will go forth to whatever it's going through to make it, it'll bring up and establish whatever it reaches. So I want to encourage you on today. There are some yeah buts in our lives, and there are some times in which we fall into the what ifs. But when we choose to remember the word of God that encourages us, increases us, and strengthens us along the way, we'll shake off that negativity. And when we let go and remember that God is with us, that brings us to today's feature song. It's a song that was one of the favorites of one of my co-executive producers, Karen Green. She loves this song. It's a very, very powerful song. And I understand why she loves it. The name of it is Let Go by DeWayne Woods. Now, so many times we go to bed and we don't sleep because we're worrying about what just happened. We're worrying about what's going to happen. We're worrying about what happened last week and how it affected today, how it affects tomorrow. We have tears in our eyes. We're so stressed out about what things happened. What if this doesn't happen? All the yeah, but that we received all throughout our day, all throughout our week, all throughout our month, all throughout our lifetimes. So we get to a point where we just keep worrying and stressing and keep getting fear implemented into our heads. But we got to evict those things out of our head by choosing to remember that God said, greater is he that is in me than he that is in the world. That we got to remember that he said that he is our shepherd, that we don't have to want for anything. We got to remember that he said that his grace is sufficient for us and his strength is made perfect in weakness. We got to remember these things. We got to remember that be careful for nothing, but in all things through prayer and supplication with thanksgiving make our requests be known to God, and the peace of God, which passeth all understanding, will keep our hearts and minds through Christ Jesus. Finally, whatsoever things are just, whatsoever things are pure, whatsoever things are lovely, whatsoever things are righteous, whatsoever things are of a good report, if it be of a good report, if it be of any virtue, if it be of any praise, think on these things. What we choose to think about can drive us up or down. So when those yeah buts come at us to cancel out all we did, we can't hold on to that. We've got to let go of it. And the song says, soon as I stopped worrying how the story ends, that's when I let go and I let God have his way. That's when things start happening. That's when things started turning around for the better. When I let go and I let God have his way. God does not wish anything just devastating to happen to us. And when things happen to us, he has a reason for it. And every step of the way, he's there with us. Every step of the way. When we even can't trace him or see him or feel him or touch him or smell him or whatever, he's always there working behind the scenes. God does his best work in the dark. When we can't see a way, when nobody else can see a way, and out of nowhere, here comes God to provide the way that nobody else can bring forth. So I encourage you on today, don't let anybody or anyone frustrate you to the point where you start to discourage yourself because they don't believe in you. If they don't believe in you, that's fine. Continue to believe in yourself and continue to got what God placed in your life, what God, whatever dream, whatever goal, whatever you're doing, that when God placed that in your life, there's a purpose for it, and there's going to be a way to get through it. If we just let go of all the negativity, if we let go of all the yeah, buts, and we let go of all the what ifs. I don't care how many times the what ifs return, and they will return. They will return because we are analytical that way. Sometimes we think too much on the wrong thing. But I encourage you, let that go and let God have his way. Let's pray. Father God, we thank you for your grace and mercy that follows us every day. We thank you for your faithfulness towards us. We thank you for every word you have sent our way and everything that it will accomplish. It may take time, but Lord, you know it will accomplish because it does not return unto you void. We know that you're not a man that shall lie, neither son of man that hath to repent. And whatever you said will come to pass. Whatever is done, you shall make it good. So Lord, we choose to remember those words, not the yeah buts and not the what ifs. And we choose to let go of that negativity. We choose to not make room for the fear, the worry, the doubt, and the stress. Although it may be hard sometimes, and sometimes it's easy to fall into that trap. But Lord, we choose to climb out of that trap and remember the words of hope and peace and strength and encouragement that we find in your word. And we will remember that, and we will stand on it, and we'll believe it, and we'll let go of all that negativity, and we'll trust you that wherever you lead us, you will take us. Whatever you have started in us, you will accomplish it. And we thank you and we praise you. No matter what it looks like, no matter what it feels like, it may be unfair and ugly and uncomfortable, but we're going to trust you and we're going to believe you and we're going to thank you. We're going to thank you before it happens. We're going to thank you when it happens. We're going to thank you after it happens, because not what you've done, but because who you are and what you are in our lives. We will thank you and glorify your name because it's worthy to be praised. In Jesus' name, amen. Now, this is the time on our devotional which we give our birthday and anniversary shout-outs. And if you have any birthday or anniversary shout-outs, as well as any comments or devotional topics that you'd like to see discussed here at the Daily Pause, you can leave those in the comment section below, or contact me on Facebook Messenger, or by email at glwilkins78@outlook.com, or by text at 864-860-1522. And today we want to wish a very special happy birthday to a former roommate of mine at Furman University, Chris Cotton. Chris, I hope you're well. I hope that God continues to bless you in all that you do, and enjoy your birthday on today. Now that's going to do it for today's edition of the Daily Pause. And I thank you for watching. I hope this devotional is a blessing and an encouragement for you to continue to believe and choose to remember the words that God placed in your heart, the positive words that we find in the Bible, on all the things that he's encouraged us with to strengthen us, to give us peace in the times of chaos. Remember those words. Let go of the strife. Let go of the stress. Let go of the worry. Let go of the tears. Weeping may endure for the night, but joy comes in the morning. Like I said earlier this week, the morning starts a second after midnight, but just because it's dark outside doesn't mean God's not there. He's always there, and he'll never put more on you than you can bear. He's always there with you to help you get through. Just let go of the worry. Let go of the doubt. and let God have his way. Continue to love each other. Continue to be safe. And remember, every day there's always time to take a pause. And Lord willing, I will see you again on tomorrow. Enjoy today's feature song, Let Go, by DeWayne Woods, composed and written by P.J. Morton, off the album Introducing DeWayne Woods and When Singers Meet, off the that's the 2006 release, produced by Verity Records. And I hope it's a blessing to you. I hope it's an encouragement to you. And I hope it really, really brightens up your day. May the God continue to strengthen you, cover you, and increase you in all that you do, say, and think on today. Thank you for watching The Daily Pause, and today's feature song starts right now. Take care, God bless, and I love you all.
Sister, you can't handle it. Let God.